If the heavens are open, that means the heavens can be closed. Give attention to closed heavens. I wanted to emphasize open heavens, but for today, we will pray. I came with prayer mantle, prayer anointing, that whatever has closed our heavens must be opened. So today's service is to address closed heavens. Honestly, I wasn't thinking of closed heavens because I'm more of a new creation person that stands in Christ, and you're just looking at the things that have been opened. But it was while I was leaving the mall this afternoon that the Lord said to me, if the heavens are opened, then the heavens can be closed. And so we're going to be looking at some of the things that has to do with closed heavens. But let's see how prayer opens your heavens. Then we'll look at some of the signs that your heavens are closed. Then we will pray. Is that okay? I'm not here for plenty revelation. And I tell you the truth, I can preach. I can give you rhema. And you'll be saying, this is deep, very deep. I don't want this is deep. I want your life to be transformed. There are times that you should sit down and ask yourself questions. At a stage, the Bible said in Ezekiel 12 that the people said, God, don't give us any prophecy again. Where are the promises? And the Lord heard them and said, what is this parable that I'm hearing in your midst? That you are saying that the vision is delayed. You are saying this and you are saying that. Today, I changed that parable. So the people had to vent their frustration to God. The same thing happened with Gideon. Gideon was hiding, and the angel came to him and said, oh, mighty man of valor, if an angel should appear to me now, I'll be petrified. I'll go around sharing testimonies. Do you know that the angel came? The angel came. Gideon knew it was an angel. Angel just looked at him. See, don't even whine me. So, you're an angel. So what? So what? Where are the promises that we have heard about? And the angel, because that was the strength that the Lord needed. You know, that reaction is a strength in your spirit that is needed for your seasons to change. I don't know if somebody is getting me. When he said, go in this your might, what he was referring to was that anger that Gideon demonstrated. You know, you can be so passive that God wants to walk, but he wants you to get up and back. He said, I will make you a new sharp threshing instrument, having teeth, meaning that your teeth is not for decoration, at times bite. Why will he make you a new sharp threshing instrument? New sharp threshing. He now says, having teeth. What is the teeth for? Hey, kabosekelekezia gabosia. This is the word of the Lord to both of you. The Lord say, bite. That's what I just heard now. This particular word, Isaiah 41, 15, is for you. Bite, bite. Concerning bite. Bite, arise, make decrees. Heaven will back it. The Bible said when the judgment of God are delayed, some nonsense continues. So at times you need to arise. Ah, kabo zege yagela he adosia. I attended a meeting recently. Last weekend, I was on the island and I ministered somewhere. And the woman of God said something. There was a way she said it. You know, you go for meetings also, you need to be watered. But she was ministering and she said, she spoke it in Yoruba, and I believe for my sake she interpreted it. She said the Lord called her name and said, Bosola, I have trained you for 18 years. If you are going through all of this, after this training of 18 years, you don't know what to do. Stay there. Immediately she said it, It was like fire was over my body because there were things I was looking at like, God, why did... And God is saying, it's like somebody that you have taught how to drive. Then you now drop car and key. Then it's raining and the person is sitting down and he's saying, I cannot go out because... Do you understand? If after all this training, you are not faced with the test of life, you cannot get up and do something, then it's your fault. And so we've been living our lives out like people that are disadvantaged. Church, listen to me. Your heavens can be opened and your heavens can be closed. And there are things that play out in your life to let you know that you are operating under a closed heaven. The Bible said, watch and pray. Most times we pray without watching. You don't know when things are closing. I had a dream recently, and I found myself somewhere. Then I left the place, you know, to go to somewhere, and it was a route that I was very, very familiar with. But immediately I stepped out, I saw that they have put barricades. I'll pass through here, I'll see a barricade. I'll pass through there, I'll see a barricade. You know, like, no, I know this place now that if you pass here, you will get there. And as I was moving, I saw an old woman that was by the side. Like, she had been looking for somebody that would fall into the trap because they have put do not trespass here. So immediately I passed and passed. I now saw the do not trespass. And I turned and I looked at her and said, I'd always known that there was... a road here. I didn't know that. She, you know how they are looking at you like, you don't enter. Then all of a sudden, we found ourselves somewhere, and I was telling her that, do you know so-so person? It's me, oh. Do you know so-so-so? It's me, oh. Do you know so-so-so? As I was saying it, her countenance was softening a bit, but it was still a bit hard. Then all of a sudden, I saw a pastor friend that appeared, and he started saying, do you know the person that did that works? She's the one. Do you know the person that did that once? And she was saying it, the countenance, and I came out of it. I said, what a dream. What a dream. God, what are you saying? I didn't even know I was going to be sharing this. And I called the pastor. It's not in the nation. I called him, and he said, doors that were open to you before, because it was a road that you knew, all of a sudden it wants to close. He said, you will have to go to court. Use your good works in the realm of the spirit, and begin to redeem. I say, hey, Kale Zogoyama. I'm not talking about myself. I'm talking about you. And really, I started looking. You know, I was telling you that all of a sudden, that was where all of that transaction. And I sat down and said, why did this door close? And why did that one close? What happened here? What happened there? It drew my attention that something was wrong. And so I began to engage the Lord and began to place a demand. So the heavens over you can't be shut. Can we look at Luke chapter 3 verse 21? Can be opened and can be shut. Luke chapter 3 verse 21. Now when all the people were baptized, it came to pass that Jesus also being baptized and what? Praying. All the people were baptized, but prayer was not attached to their baptism. So take note of that detail. That Jesus Christ being baptized and praying, what happened? The heaven was opened. So if I want to understand this scripture, it means that prior to the baptism, the heaven was locked. Before this time, the heaven, because it was after this now, he now started this. The heaven was locked. When the heaven was open, give us 22. And the Holy Ghost descended in a bodily shape like a dove. So tomorrow we're going to be seeing some indices of open heavens. One of them is what you are seeing here. And a voice came from heaven which said, thou art my beloved son, in thee I am well pleased. In some other renditions, you will see the continuation where he says, thou art my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased. The next thing is, hear ye him. When the heavens are open, men hear you. Hey, even when you say rubbish, it is not a product of what you said, but that an announcement and a declaration has been made. Hear ye him. The rocks, we hear you. The rivers, we hear you. Children, we hear you. Social media, we hear you. All of a sudden, you just see that everybody's listening to you. Why? Because the heavens have been opened and the Lord has uttered his voice, which is, hear ye him. But what opened the heavens? Jesus Christ being baptized and praying. The other people were baptized. We did not see prayers there. But Christ being baptized and praying, we see that the heavens over him were open. And you can know when your heavens are open. John chapter 1, verse 51. Give me that quickly. Calibra Zodoboshe. This is Jesus having a conversation with Philip, and he said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto you, after now, you shall see what? I need your feedback. After now, you shall do what? You shall see heaven opens. You shall see. The first thing I want to say is, you can see. That means you can be aware that your heavens are open. At the same time, you can be unaware. So the Bible says in, is it 2 Corinthians 3 now? Or is it 2? It says, why we look not at the things that are seen, but at the things that are not seen. You will see heaven. That means you need another pair of eyes to see, to know if your heavens are open or your heavens are shut. And you should know. The children of Issachar were men that had understanding of the times. They knew what was happening. They knew what they should do. They did it in the season, and their brethren were at their command. But we had another set of people that did not understand the time, Jerusalem. The Bible said Jesus wept over Jerusalem and said, how come you did not know the time of your visitation and the things that were ordained for your peace? So it is not good enough for you to just see the heavens open. There must be angelic ascensions and descensions. I've said two things that I will emphasize tomorrow as signs that your heavens are open: the presence of the Holy Ghost and the ministry of angels. They are signs, but that's not my emphasis for today. Tomorrow we will deal with them. Your heavens, you can know that your heavens are open. You just know, and all of a sudden, favor start coming. All of a sudden, things are, you should be observant enough. This is like the sixth week of every weekend I'm in Lagos. I have to ask the Lord, what's going on with Lagos? What's going on with Lagos? I know you told me then, Abuja, Lagos, Kano. Then I gave a lot of attention to Abuja and did a bit in Lagos. And after COVID, I was telling Apostle that ministry is not for the faint-hearted. It's not beans. How many of you have been in this church long enough? From that place to the other place, to this place, to the next place. Because this is refueling, no. This is not bus stop. So that word, this is refueling. This is not bus stop. But you need a lot of chutzpah. You need a lot of strength to be able to. You must be aware of what's going on. Some months back, the Lord rebuked me, said, I told you, Lagos, you are not giving Lagos attention. And honestly, even at that, I wasn't. But back to back to back to back, even that meeting last weekend, I was supposed to go through Abuja, fly into Abuja, then the next day fly home. And then I got that meeting, all we needed to do, because it didn't change my time of movement. I had to now pass through Lagos instead of going to Abuja. Pass through Lagos, and I asked the Lord, what is happening with Lagos? Because it will be foolishness for the Lord to be showing you something who is as blind as my servant. That's one of the characteristics of open heavens. When heavens are open, revelations come. Understanding comes. Light comes.
I will just repeat these things in greater detail tomorrow. So you must be able to watch. Jerusalem were not perceptive. They didn't have discernment. They didn't know the time of their visitation. They didn't know the season. It's not, and the children of Issachar, they understood times. Of what use is it if I know that it's planting season and I did not plant? Did you get me? Oh, it's rainy season and I'm supposed to carry an umbrella when I'm going out. I observe the wind. It looks like it will rain. I don't have a car. I did not carry a raincoat. I didn't carry anything. What benefit was that observation? Because rain will beat me. Do you understand? So to understand times and not know the things that you should do during that time is an error. Then for you to know the things you are supposed to do and not do it is also a problem. So if the Lord is saying open heavens, that means for some of us, our heavens are shut. And for some of us, it's not that they are shut, but they are not opened at the level that they should open. Have you seen some doors that they open a bit and then they shut back? Have you seen those kind of doors? The Lord uses everything to talk to me. He said, see, at times you pray and it's opening. You don't stay enough for the elasticity level to break such that that door cannot shut again. You just stay there. It opens a bit. It's like you squeeze like this. You know how to squeeze and pass through a door. And you pass through, it shuts again. After a season, you will come back to that place. You say, why don't you stay there and raise the gate down? So that anytime you want to pass, you can pass. You have access. You have access. So, some of us have seen some favors, but the favors are in trickles. On Thursday, we were having all night, and I told myself, called my workers, and I said, from now till I feel that we should stop every week, all night. One week, one day a week, all night. Not convenient for you. Not convenient for me. I said, you see, on Friday, I'm traveling. But this all night, we will do it. And one of the things we're praying, God, we don't want there shall be showers of blessing. We don't want showers again. Showers end. We want flood. We want rain. We don't want your blessings and trickles in our lives. So some of us, it's not like you don't see these things come, but they come in trickles. Somebody blessed you in January. The next time you got a blessing was April. The next time you will get is Happy Christmas. No. I placed the church on a 30 days challenge. Told them to take the word of God. 2 scriptures. I say you don't need 10 scriptures. He daily loads us with benefits. And his mercies are new every morning. I say every day you get up, tell God, where's the benefit for today? And where's the newness of your mercy? I say, if you stand on the word of God, not one of his word will fall to the ground. In 30 days' time, at least you can get 30 testimonies. By the all night, I told them, double it. 2 people got free cars. Our sister just got that. I think you need a car. Come and carry this car. Does it come like that? Another one, a ministry just sent car. Crazy testimonies. And I told them, I said, don't say because I said 30 days challenge, you now let it go. Every day I look for, I journal, I ask the Lord for today, where's the blessing? And it must not be monetary. Do you understand? Because at times if it's not money testimony, we don't see the goodness of God. It could be that you had a dream that was so clear, telling you what to do. That's the good. Before you were not dreaming, now you got a dream. You got clear instruction. That's the blessing of God. Could be healing. Could be for your brother. It could be for your sister. But just be sensitive and look around you to see that the favors of the Lord Jesus, I saw rain over this place. It will pour. It will pour. It will pour. It will pour. It will. We partner with the angels. We partner with rainmakers. If men can sit down and make rain, kabashate kaye, zekarabaza, zekerigade, zubarakata, makelegede, zegayamama, radozakayegede, leparagadozia.
January this year, during the fasting, the Lord told me, he said, when you see drought and dryness, don't sit down. There's something you can do about it. I say, really? He said, yes. I said, what do you do? He said, until the Spirit be poured from on high and the wilderness becomes a fruitful field and the fruitful field be counted for a forest. He said, so every time you are faced with a wilderness, don't sit down. Do something about it. James chapter 5 verse 16. I'm already stirring your river. I'm stirring your river to pray. Confess your faults one to another and pray for one another that you may be healed. The effectual, fervent prayer. Please give me amplified translation. We'll come back to King James, but let's look at this. All right, the last phrase, the what? Earnest. Earnest means what? Heartfelt, continued prayer of a righteous man makes what? Not any kind of prayer. The Bible said when Peter was locked up, prayers were made. No. Please, I want to speak Pidgin English. Then cook prayer. No, it's not that they came and they said they prayed. When the Bible said prayers were made, you know how you sit down? Yes. You make the prayer. You construct. It was strategic. It was intentional. It was fervent. It was continuous. They entered a realm. They were placing a demand on heaven. They were warning God in quotes. Peter cannot go. They took James, but Peter cannot go. Peter cannot go. Peter cannot go. Their voices was resonating in the heaven. Heaven had to send an angel and give the angel instruction that say, don't make any mistake. Oh. You must open all the doors, because when your heaven is open, your doors will be open. Who am I talking to? When your heaven is open, your doors will be open. The Bible said the angel descended into the prison and the doors, number one door, number two door, number three door. The angel knew that the intensity of the prayer, he could not let Peter go. He had to carry Peter, escorted him. And the Bible said when he got to the iron gates, so there are doors and there are iron. You are dealing with iron gate. You are praying like somebody that is dealing with wooden door that you just do like this and he opened. The Bible said doors. He said the iron gate. The Bible said it opened of his own accord. Why will it not open when the heavens are already open? It will open. By the time the disciples saw Peter, they thought it was his angel. And they were not angel. No, we don't want angel. It's Peter we want. Hey, Jesus, what brought it? Continued prayer. When the heavens were shut against Hannah, when your heavens are shut, your womb be shut now. Part of the sign that you know that your heavens are shut, you will be seeing a lot of things that you'll be explaining it. You will, William Branham said, you call it cancer, I call it demon. You will labor so much, but you will get little. You will see the oppression of devourers in your life. You will be living on past glory in those days. In those days, when I was doing like this, and when I was doing like that, we used to have two cars. Now we have one. Or the one I have. You know, when somebody gets something, we are not the first. We have gotten it before. But that is no longer your what? Your reality. It's showing you that things are out of order. You begin to have dryness. Scarcity of testimony is in your life. Lack becomes a norm. Frustration is there.
You are investing and you are not seeing it. You want to read your Bible, it's no longer pleasurable. Prayer looks like hard work. It's showing you that the heavens are brass. That something is wrong with your heavens. You must be observant enough to see it. So Hannah was operating under closed heavens. And she was not aware. When your heavens are shut, then there is disfavor. The Bible said, when God saw that Jacob loved Rachel more than Leah, he shut what? Yeah, the heavens was what he shut. The heaven that gives rain, the heaven that gives children, the heaven that gives everything, he closed it. All of a sudden, your spiritual womb is shut. You can't carry things to full term. You can't carry vision to full term. It's coming, it's not, you know, you can't push further with it. But Hannah, one of the rare women of faith, one of the women that tapped into a dispensation that was beyond her. Oh, yes. The Bible said in Hebrews 11 that they saw the promises. They embraced it from afar. The Holy Ghost had not been given us at that time. But Hannah was one of the women to receive the Holy Ghost. Say, Pastor Fanny, you are pretty error. What was told to the disciples in Acts chapter 2, you were drunk 9 a.m., was the same thing they told Anna. 9 a.m., you are drunk. Meaning, this time around, before she will go to Shiloh, tomorrow I will look at altars and open heavens as part of what I want to talk about. She will go to Shiloh and she will stroll and stroll out. But this year, before she will go with makeup, and there's nothing wrong with makeup, but I tell you the truth, there are times that you are desperate, that you won't even know that you did not carry some things. Because if she was a woman that was well made up, Eli will not look at her like a drunkard. The reason why some of us have not broken into some promises in our lives is because we are still well behaved. A drunk man, we see road, we see trailer and say, stop. A drunk man, we jump. There are leaps of faith that you need to take. That it takes you being drunk. God will tell you, go and get land. How much is in your account? 1,000 naira. Hey, you must be a drunkard. Am I talking to somebody? No, the reason why, because faith is risk. The reason why you have not pushed is because you are still very normal. You are still okay. You can calculate. God, where did it come from? My uncle does not have. My sister does not have. Tinubu have done this. There is no fuel. There is no that. COVID has come and all of that. A drunk man does not know if there's an electric pole in front of him. A drunk man does not know if a trailer, if he's crossing the road, he does not know. Something has overwhelmed him. It is that thing that pushes him into his destiny. Anna was drunk. Anna was drunk. It's no longer, am I not more than 10 sons? There's a place for son, there's a place for husband. That your deception ends. Before you tell me, am I not, you give me 2 portions, then I'll be satisfied. Oh God, your name is not baby. Your name is babe. Hallelujah. What I need is what? Baby. Not babe. Hallelujah. Did you hear me? Yes. Don't be telling me that. Am I not worth more than? No, no, no. Can I send you a message? Come and bring cup for me. Go and wash my slippers. Help me carry my bag. You are not worth more than. You have your place of value as husband, but not as a son. When Hannah got to that place this year, she didn't carry trolley when she was going to Shiloh. She tied her wrapper. Maybe her blouse was like this. Maybe her hair was scattered. Maybe she was rolling on the floor because a drunk man is not organized. The clothes is falling. They are trying to cover him. He's doing like this, doing like that. She was doing all kinds of things. And Eli said, what is wrong with you? She said, no, I'm not drunk. It's a trap. My heavens are closed. Things are not okay. My heavens are shut. Where is that God? And that year, listen to me. It is not sleeping with your husband 10,000 times. Hannah has been sleeping with her husband. But one prophetic word by the priest. Why are you not coming to church? You know it's ovulation period. We want to. You know, get sense. This time does not go out by ovulation period. What you are dealing with is not physical. If it's physical, then you can be calculating all of that. Hannah went to the presence of God. When she came out, the barren has born seven. She didn't just come out with Samuel. She came out with what? With other children. The signs of close heaven are that your womb has shut. You can't carry things to full term in the realm of the spirit. He said the people have come to the place of birth, but there is no strength. Your heavens are shut. No strength to push. No strength for your child. 9 months work was to be wasted at the delivery room. Not 9 months work, because we don't know the number of months it took before the seed entered. So if they calculate that one and now add the 9 months of pregnancy, for some people maybe it's 1.5 years. I don't know if you understand, of work. Then after you have done 1.5 years work, you now get to the place of push. They say, Madam, push. You say, hey. I don't have strength. Madam, you will die. And this baby too will die. And so you will see the doctors, what are they doing? So one lady said, I just started feeling sleepy. You see, one kind of sleep that they could not explain. I say, it's the first time I've heard that somebody's in labor pain and the person is sleeping. She said, deep sleep. We just pull her in. They started hitting her. Started doing everything to check her. Woe betide you that when you come to that day, you don't have people like this to jack you up. Yes, that's the time that all of a sudden pastor says, come and pray every Thursday. All of a sudden say, come and do this. Come and do that. And because you don't have understanding, you see, this is our pastor, eh? Every day, pray. Every day, pray. No, they are helping you. They are beating you. They are hitting you. They are putting their leg on your back. They know that if they leave you, no result will come. She even herself, she'll be asking herself, where is this instruction coming from? But all of a sudden, something just says, do that all night. Push the people. Press. Contend for your inheritance. It will not be convenient at all. Next week, I fix the all night for Tuesday. I'm entering home on Monday. I'm traveling to Jos on Wednesday. I'm doing all night on Tuesday. Even me, I'm asking myself, you well? I say, no. It is because I know well. That is, I want to be well. Yes. You get to a place that you are tired of the status quo. You get to a place that you are telling yourself, is there no more to it? The earnest, heartfelt, continued prayer. This kind of prayer is not prayer that you pray once. Continue, you keep hitting. You keep hitting. You know, there's a law of physics where you are hitting a same spot. The same spot. Not hit here, go. No, that tree, you are using your cutlass and you are doing it like this. One day it will fall and you'll not say, hey, sudden miracle. It's not sudden. There is nothing like sudden. It's the accumulation of strength The woman is having contraction every 3 hours, before you know, 1 hour, before you know, 15 minutes later, 1 minute, no space, 1 minute, no space. What? At that stage, God is saying what? Hit, 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 continuous. Keep hitting it, keep hitting it. Keep, get up every time you open your eyes, 3 a.m., pray. Tomorrow, 3 a.m., pray. Some days, put your leg inside water, pray. Continue, continue. One day, you just see that something broke. You needed to strike at that level at a particular time. The heartfelt, continuous prayer, it makes tremendous power available, which is dynamic. So at times when you are praying those prayers, maybe it was a health issue and you actually thought that all those energy you were generating was for your health, but you don't know that the power is dynamic. That prayer that you were saying, God, hear me, hear me, hear me, you were praying, pray, 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 pray. No. It begins to touch one person. Things start happening in your life that you can't explain. There are things that you can't, how? In tracking part of the testimonies, one of the times I was in Lagos and had to stay for close to 7 days doing different things, I saw that I had sent some of my things back home with my team. I needed to pick one or two things. I didn't envisage I would stay that long. So I went to a mall to pick some things. And when I got there, I picked something. And while I was weighing the price, because it was a bit pricey, whether I should get it and whatever, a lady walked in, and long story short, eventually I showed her. I said, she looked at me and she said, you look like somebody I know. I said, really? I was wearing shades and many things. You know, at times you want to just enter some place quietly without doing God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. You know, at times. So I said, really? She said, yes. I said, Oh, she said, one lady I follow on Instagram. I said, really? I said, what's her name? She said something like prophetess. Immediately she said, pro. I knew she had caught me. Prophetess Far. I said, I'm the one. And she was like, hey, God bless me. Anyway, I was looking at the bag and I said, how do you think I've called it? It was a bag. What do you think of this? And she said, oh, it's good. And long story short, it's a mall that had nothing less than like 30 shops. As I dropped it, she said, ma, please, I want to pay. You've blessed me. And I went home, I said, no. It's only God that can tell me, go there this time, then enter the shop, then also tell another person, come. Then of all the shops, meet here. Is somebody getting me? Those things, it is the dynamic operation that comes through prayer. So when you are praying in tongues, in your mind, because you say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I'm having a migraine, heal me. In your mind, this tongue is headache. That's what your mind thinks. But the dynamism of the spiritual language is that it is telling that person, 3 a.m., she will be there. It is pulling people, telling somebody, leave America, telling you, you want to pay for this flight, pay for this other one. You pay, you sit by the, oh Jesus. You will just see that you sat by somebody. You'll be asking yourself, how come you sat and the person will ask you one question that will lead to something, and all of a sudden something that you have been praying. No, it is prayer that brings alignment. It brings the heaven and the earth into alignment. When your heavens are open, it will be done on earth as it is in heaven. When your heavens are shut, it will not be done in your life as it is in heaven. Open heaven is synonymous with alignment with your heavens and your earth. When they are in sync, then your heavens are open. Heaven is moving this way, you are moving that way. Heaven is going that way, you are going that way. But when heaven is moving this way and you are going that way, then your heavens are shut. And what makes those things open? Prayer. Effectual, fervent prayer. Dynamic in its workings. Give me the next verse. I'll try to tie it up there. Kalebrazodobosia 17. Elijah was a human being. I love that. He was a man.
with a nature as we have. Elijah used to get hungry. Elijah, Akalia. I was telling my elder sister, I said, I got to a place one day, I told God, I said, God, you don't used to answer prayer without fasting. I said, God, you are my father today. I'm not fasting. Just answer this prayer without fasting because I will eat. Meaning that Elijah was a human being. Am I talking to somebody? I said, this one, I'm telling you beforehand, there's a street in your world that say eat for the journey is far. I said, that's the street that I am in. I'm not in the street of fasting. This journey is very far. I will eat, oh God. I will eat. But there are other seasons. Back to back fasting. Back the dynamism of it. Do you understand? Elijah, I'm telling you, I am using myself so that you don't put us on a high pedestal. There are times I don't feel like praying. The only difference between me and you is whether I feel like praying or I don't feel like praying. I pray. Hey, no. You think it's every time that one wants to be pacing the floor. And you no. Elijah was a human being with feelings, with affections, with a constitution like ours. But irrespective of all the drama around him, we don't know if Elijah was married. Maybe that was the day that Elijah is saying, I want to go out. And his wife stands in front of the gate and says, if you don't satisfy me, you are going nowhere. Maybe that's the day that his wife said, are you a man of God? Prove your calling. Hey, he was a man that had issues. Things were playing out in his life. But irrespective of what was going on in his life, the intimidation of Jezebel, the prophet that he could not see, no encouragement from anything. The Bible said he prayed earnestly and he shut the heavens. That's where I'm going to. Rain did not fall. Because he shut the heavens. And when it was time to open the heavens, he prayed again and he opened the heavens. If you stay with 1 Kings, you will not know a behind the scene. You will just see Elijah appear and say, there will be no rain by my word. Then you now, Mumu, you will just go and stand before Pharaoh and say, there will be no rain by my word. Hey, Pharaoh will so beat you. No. Because behind the scene is that James was able to see that when he said there will be no rain, he didn't sit down. Before he made that statement, he prayed. So it was from that place he released a prophetic decree. And then when he told them, go and eat, the Bible said he tucked his head underneath and he prayed. And what happened? The heavens were opened and rain fell. When your heavens are open, there will be blessings, favor, good things, miracles. People just favor you. People just love you. People just see you. Have you paid for that? Let me pay for you. Have you bought fuel? Let me do this for you. If you stay from January to December without somebody doing you any good, your heavens are closed. And if you also, tomorrow I'll look at it all times, because we want people to be doing for us. Have there been instances too that I've been somewhere that I also saw somebody and my spirit say, pay that thing. Some of those seeds are the things that speaks for us. Rise to your feet. I don't know what part of the ministration has blessed you, but we are going to pray. And I'm not going to give you a prayer point. The basic prayer point for today is whatever has shut my heavens, Lord, by your mercy, let it be open. If it's something I need to see, to change, because at times, instructions need to come for you to know what to do. If it's discernment, whatever it is, we are going to pray for the next 10 minutes. After that, I hand over to Pastor. I'm not giving you a prayer point. If you like the way your heavens are, be okay. You can sit down. But if you are tired of the way that things are in your life, kabaraba zirigede zimbrigede regede ya langaba shataba lagade. By your mercy, O God, rabakondo zekabaradia. By your mercy, O God, lante kabaradosia. By your mercy, O God, aratole zekebosa rade kerebosa zekebosa 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 zekebosa. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, your name is to be praised. This is an appointment with destiny. La brakete deke sete kala pa 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 pa. Le cavazzo poti le hash e me sempre in tora abbigazia le capato lumenta e la robin zigaba renedisha patio le his patava. Lord, by your mercy, every way the heavens have been shut, every way my womb has been shut, every way my doors have been shut, doors of favor, doors of blessings, everywhere they have been shut, by your mercy, let the heavens open. Look at those specific areas. No help. It is only God that can open your heavens. Elijah prayed and the heavens were open. Take the hand of one person. Take the hand of one person and pray fervently. Pray louder, faster, louder, faster, with fervency. When your heavens are open, the sun will rise over you. He said, and your light will break forth as the morning, and your health will spring forth speedily, and the glory of the Lord shall be your regard. Those are the things you see when your heavens are open. Change your prayer partner. Take another prayer partner. Take another prayer partner. One will chase 1,000. Two will put 10,000 to flight. Multiply strength. My Father, let the heavens over this house be open. Where the heavens have been shut, show us mercy. Show us mercy over my family, over my ministry, over Harvest City. Show us mercy. Change your prayer partner. Take another prayer partner. Change.
Let's
singlehood to your husband's house. Your finances are increasing. When your heavens are open, there are movements. He said, you will see, you will discern, you will know. Every partner Now break your hands. Say, every power that is responsible for shutting my doors, begin to address them. Bind them. Break their hold. It is not ordinary that doors that opened before, all of a sudden they are closing. Every power, every force that's responsible for closed heavens, break. Oppressions of delay, be broken. We bind you. We cast you out.
You everlasting doors, you everlasting doors.
Speak to those forces. Loose my heavens. Loose my doors. Every herald. Shut in your door.
Let every receive.
Demonic spirits sponsoring those attacks. We bind you.
We command you to part.
In Jesus' name, look up. We are going to pray this prayer again. The Bible said, in Joshua chapter 6 verse 1, he said Jericho was straightly shut because of the children of Israel. Nobody went out, nobody came in. There are some doors that are shut because of you. That's a siege. And do you know that at times the enemy does not allow you to, he doesn't do it in a way that you are, it's glaring for you to fight. I remember one year I had a dream and I saw myself and some others in a story building. The story building was long, it was like a mall. Inside there was a car, chairs, some things. But when I looked out through the window, I saw that there were soldiers all around and we were fenced. You know, he gives you, I better pass my neighbor. So at least you have Jen now. So you will not ask for what is yours. If he knows that he will not give you at all, you will know that something is wrong and you will pray. At least you have a car. But they will push the car. At least you have small. You understand? And I looked through the window and I saw those soldiers. Then I was telling the people with me, I said, we can leave. Oh, the fence is short. We can leave. One of them was now telling me, he said, then don't worry, then the soldiers have already told us that very soon they will release us. I said, see, I would have left this place since, but I know that if I leave, because of you people, my mind will be here. I said, as you are seeing me now, we are living here, not soldiers. Oh yeah, let's get out of this place. That was how I woke up. Some of you, there's a siege around you. Jericho was fenced. It was shot. No, they didn't die on time. Oh, that means there's still food. Nothing is coming. Nothing is going out. You will not die immediately, but gradually you are whittling down. You are whittling down until the, because if nothing is coming in, what you have inside will expire. At least
least you have 200k in your account. In my place, they will say it's when money meets money in your hand, that's when you are rich. You have 200k, you are okay. But you spend 5,000 today, yesterday 10,000. In another 1 month, there will be no longer 200,000. If nothing is worth entering, there is a demonic shrink. Powers that sponsor that in our life, catch fire. Turn it to prayer. Soldiers in the spirit sponsoring those attacks. Shutting things down in our life. Is that how you are addressing that power? You clap your hands and say, break, 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 catch fire, be destroyed, lose me, lose me, lose my family, lose my finance, lose, break your hold, let me go, break your hold.
Lose your hold in the name of Jesus. We step on your fire, Lord.
Strike, strike, strike. Continue. Shoot your arrow. Don't shoot it three times. Shoot it. Lose my children. Lose my children. Lose my husband. Lose my ministry. Lose us. Lose us. Lose us.
Lose them, lose your children, lose them in the name of Jesus. We come with a name that is above every name, in the mighty name of Jesus. Your foul spirit, your Satan,
spirit of setbacks, spirit of delay,
spirit of stagnation,
spirit of closed doors.
Be destroyed.
He said, I ain't coming.
Fire, 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 fire,
Jesus' name. Some years back, I had a dream. In fact, I woke up with a dream this morning, with a consciousness of it. In the dream, I was having a dream. In that dream, I had a vision. I don't know if you understand. In the dream, I was sleeping. In that dream, I had a vision. In the vision, a man of God appeared, and he pointed at a door, and he looked at me. The door was slightly opened. In fact, I woke up with it this morning. I didn't know I was going to share it, meaning that is the word for the house. And the man pointed at the door and he said, Romans 5:2. Romans 5:2. The vision lifted. Then I was in the dream. In that dream, I started looking for my Bible, asking myself, was in Romans 5:2? Was in Romans 5:2? I searched for my Bible. Eventually, I saw my Bible. When I opened my Bible to Romans 5:2 in the dream, they had poured ink on that page. So in the dream, I could not read Romans 5:2. Then I came out. This kind of dream, is it a dream that a human being should forget? Forgot the dream. It was when I was doing something in the bathroom much later. I just heard Romans 5:2. I screamed, Romans 5:2. My husband said, what's going on? I said, Romans 5:2. Romans 5:2. Romans 5:2. I said, in the dream, I could not read it. Romans 5:2. They brought ink. They brought ink. I took it. And the Bible said, give me King James. Give me King James. We have access by faith into this grace. So he was showing me an open door and he was telling you, the door is open. Access. Give us now that amplifier that you just put. Put it back. You have access by faith. I'm not telling you my story. It came. I know how God speaks to me, so it's for the house. He said, through him also we have access. You have an entrance. Introduction by faith into this grace. Grace is all encompassing. It is wealth, it is favor, it is healing. You have access by faith. So I asked the Lord, why is it that I could not read in the dream? And the Lord said,
a great and effectual door has been opened, but there are many adversaries. I heard it now. That's the last prayer I want to take. That's where the thing came. The Lord said, the door has been opened, but there are what? The door has been opened, but there are what? You are waiting for prayer points. You don't want to remove the adversary. You say, lift up your heads, O ye gates. You adversary, at the point of breakthrough. The king said, who is at the door? He said, Haman is there. Your enemy at the point of your breakthrough. If you don't know what to do with your enemies, it is your fault. Today, Kampayana, in the name that is above every name, every adversary at the point of my breakthrough, catch fire. Be destroyed. Every power at the point of my toe. In Jesus' name, listen. It was time for a shift. But who was at the door? It was Haman. That time that the woman is looking at you and is saying, this girl is respectful. Oh, I want to marry her. My son should marry her. That's the time that an adversary will be there. We say, she not get respect. And all of a sudden, something that was supposed to happen will not happen. That time that they are assessing your file, they are looking at who to promote. That exact moment, that's the time that you had issue with somebody. The person did not come since. It's that time that your boss put in, you just enter. He said, what are you doing? I want to promote my people. This person, do you know her? We don't promote her. It ends there. Power Zakabaya. Zeketapa. Zuntekete. Zepalata. Rateke. Zeyadaba. Lanteka. Ratos. At the point of my breakthrough, catch fire. We release the judgment of God against you. We command you to be destroyed. 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 Powers with evil reports. Powers that speak negatively. Lempayana, we break your hold. Lente paradosia. That mountain before have a city be made a plain. We break your home. We break your home. Can you lift up your hands? Lift up your hands. The Bible said, let your prayers come like incense and the lifting up of your hands as the evening sacrifice. So this is a battle stand in the realm of the spirit. Every power and every force that is contending against your destiny, in the name that is above every name, even the name of Jesus, we say be destroyed. Can I hear a believing amen?
Amen.
We say be destroyed.
Amen.
Adversaries at the point of our breakthroughs, we break your heart. Can I hear a believing amen?
Amen.
Every Haman at the point of my door be disgraced. Can I hear a believing amen?
Amen.
Every door that have been shut because of me, I command you to be open in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We
We command those doors be open in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus said, Ephata, be opened. Ephata, be opened. Ephata, be opened. By the blood of the eternal covenant, the Lord told me, he said, when you are dealing with doors, use the blood. He said, the blood is a breaker. He said, that is why I said, put it at the doorpost and the lintel. Anytime you are dealing with a demonic door, then use the blood. We apply the blood. We apply the blood. We apply the blood. We apply the blood to those doors in the spirit. By the blood, come out of Pharaoh's stronghold. By the blood, come out of captivity. By the blood, come out of captivity. When the blood is applied, you come out of the stronghold of Pharaoh and you enter into your promised land. Take one step and say, by the blood, I am out and I enter. Now rejoice there. You have the victory.
Everybody
say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church
say
amen.